Guys, welcome back to another video of Fox Android. So this video will be in continuation of our Kotlin series that we have started, right? So this is the second video. In the first one, we have learned that how to handle a button on click event, right? When a user presses a button, how to handle that event, right? So in this video, we're going to learn how to switch activities when a user presses any button, how to make him go to another activity, right? So without much ado, let's get started. So okay guys, to start off with, first we'll go to our XML file, right? So we'll change this to activity A, right? And we'll change the text size to 40 SP. Now we'll add a button, wrap content, and we'll give it ID of second act button. So when user presses this button, he'll be redirected to another activity, right? So we'll just set the text as second activity. Now we'll set its constraints. The horizontal constraints will be with the parent. The bottom one will be with the parent as well. This is okay. So that is it. That is all we need to do with our XML file. Now let us quickly add another activity that will be opened up when user clicks on this button, right? Empty activity. We'll just name as second activity, right? Now let's quickly go to the XML of second activity and add a text view. Activity B. I guess there is some typo. And we'll set the text size as 40 SP. And now we'll set the constraints, right? We'll set all the constraints to parent. Okay, perfect. So that is it. That is all we need to do in the XML. Now we'll just go to the backend code of main activity, right? So we already know that how to handle a button click event, right? So I'm not gonna discuss that. So now in Java, we used to make a intent object, then we used to call the method start activity. So here for making the object of intent class, we'll use val keyword, as I've told you in the last video, that we'll be using this val keyword for making the variables, right? So the first argument will be the context of the existing activity, right? And the second argument is the class, the second activity. So in Java we used to do second activity dot class, but here second activity to this dotted colons, right? Then class dot Java. This is how you pass the class as in second argument. Then we'll as usual call start activity method and pass the intent, right? So that is all we need to do to call the second activity when a user presses a button, right? Now I'll just quickly install this app to my cell phone and we'll check if it is working fine or not, right? So okay guys, the app has been installed to my cell phone. As you can see on my mobile screen, we have this activity A. So when I presses this second activity button, we go to activity B. Now if I again presses back button, then we press this second activity, we go to activity B. So I guess we have successfully implemented the code for switching the activity on button click, right? I hope you guys have understood the code. So far we have learned two concepts, how to handle a button click event and how to switch to another activity, right? So if you have any doubt, you can always ask me in the comment section or you can DM me on Instagram. The Instagram username is there on your screen right now. And if you're new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and press the bell notification icon. And if you like the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button as well. So that is it for today's video. See you in another video. Bye.